I just finished making this USB powered DIY ice cooler air conditioner. In today's video, I'm going to show you step by step the entire build. I'll show you all the parts I used, how much I paid for them, and I'll show you some thermal imaging using my FLIR 1 thermal camera. As I'm building my DIY ice cooler air conditioner today, I'm going to be cooling myself off with my other DIY ice cooler air conditioner. I'll put a link to the build video for this one at the end of today's video. Let's go over the build plan for today's video. I've put together a list of parts and the prices to break down this whole build. This entire plan only has 6 components. We have a fan, an outlet hose, an inlet hose, and 2 flanges and the cooler. That's it. Why did I choose this cooler over the cooler from my previous build? This cooler has an insulated lid, it has a drain, and a larger ice capacity than this cooler. It also has a longer lid, which gives me room for my bigger fan and my outlet hose. And the price at $59 isn't horrible, and it's the cheapest cooler on wheels I could find that has all of these features. The fan I chose for today's build is a 7-inch USB fan. USB connections are pretty universal, and this fan is surprisingly powerful. Not the case with a lot of the USB fans on the market. I bought quite a few for this project just to find the right one. I could have chosen a 120-volt fan, but this fan is not very portable, and you really couldn't take this thing camping. And at 6.75 watt hours, this USB fan will have very low power consumption. My total cost for the build today using this cooler is $127.50. But if you use the cooler from my previous build, you could build this for under $100. To start my build, I need to drill 2 holes in the lid of this cooler, one for the fan and one for the outlet hose. The hole that I've cut on the top of the cooler lid is going to be big enough for the fan to pass through. The hole on the bottom side of the lid, I want to be a little smaller so that the fan will have a little lip to rest on. My adjustable hole saw works perfect for this. I'll leave an affiliate link for this and all the products in today's video in the description down below. And if you use them, it'll help out the channel. Let's make sure this thing fits down in there. Oh yeah. I really like the way the foam kind of holds the fan into place. Let's get this base off of here. It looks like there's just one Phillips screw that holds this base on there. Let's take this thing apart. The 2 hole sizes that I ended up drilling was 7 inches on the top and 6 inches on the bottom. Next, I need to drill a 3-inch hole for my outlet hose, and I'm just gonna center it up wherever it sits flat here. Next, I need to mount this collar flange on the top of the cooler. That's gonna hold our flex form hose for our outlet side. On the bottom side of the cooler, I've got this flange. That's gonna hold our flexible aluminum conduit. To attach these flange fittings, I just used some zip screws, and I tightened them down by hand because I don't want to strip out the holes. I'm going to use a razor knife to cut my flex form hose right around 18 inches. I'm going to use zip screws to attach this to the flange. I'll do the same thing with the aluminum ductwork for the bottom side, except I'm only going to cut it 12 inches. My thought process with the aluminum conduit is that aluminum conducts cold and it'll help to transfer some of that cold to the outlet air. And as the ice melts, this will drop down. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. I might end up cutting this down a little bit in the future. Next, we'll get the fan mounted in here permanently. Another reason why I chose this specific fan is because it has three speeds. 1, 2, 3, and a long press gives you hyper speed. And even when this thing is in the hyper speed mode, it's pretty quiet. Before I fill this thing up with ice, let's use the FLIR 1 thermal camera and we'll get some before and after footage. So here's the before. There you can see the fan there. The fan's inside of there, it's pretty hot. There's our exhaust tube. The exhaust tube is there. There's the lid. Wow, you can see my handprint, that's pretty cool. And then inside, there's the inside of it. Let's fill this thing up with some ice. We'll let it run for a little while and then we'll film it again. All right, that's 40 pounds of ice. I don't think I can put too much more in there because of the length of my ductwork for my outlet tube. Let's turn this thing on and see how cold it gets. I'm gonna let it run for 15 minutes on high and then we'll check back. All right, I've set up this little unscientific experiment. I've got two thermometers here and this thing's been going for about 30 minutes. So this thermometer here shows that it's 100 degrees today in my garage. Over here, you can see the air coming out of the outlet hose. It's about 78, 75, 78 degrees. What's the humidity in Las Vegas today, Siri?
The humidity will be up to 10% today.
All right, so 10% humidity. It's a pretty dry heat here, but I got 100 degrees here, and then I've got 78 degrees a few inches away from the outlet hose. It's getting kind of windy out there. It's kind of ruining my little experiment here. Not that it's all that scientific to begin with, but let's get some FLIR 1 thermal imaging data. This thermometer is plus or minus 5 degrees, but we can see that the cold air coming out of the tube here, you can see that cold air, it's turned the tube cold and it's a different color. The cooler is a different color because it's warm. You can see that little motor in there. That little motor's pretty hot. And then we've got our two different thermometers. There's our two different thermometers. That one says 102. This thing says 108. So we're plus or minus 4 or 5 degrees on the FLIR 1 imaging. Let's open this thing up and just kind of take a peek inside. We could see that ice down there is 32 degrees. Well, that should be about right, actually, 32 degrees for ice. So there's our thermal imaging. We can see this is the after images, and it's kind of interesting. You can see that this is where the cooler is inefficient and leaking there on the corners. Power consumption, run time. How much ice does this thing use? Does this thing even really work? I'm working on a performance testing video for this unit, and when I'm finished with it, I'll put a link to it right here. Until then, check out this video. This is the build video for the ice cooler air conditioner I made in a previous video. Let me know what you think about each one. I'm glad you watched, and I hope you'll watch again.